So what happens when a bikepacking bag maker makes a pannier? Well, we're gonna find out today, folks. Today, I'm gonna give you guys a first look at the Nano Pannier by Revelate Design. Find out what I like and dislike about it so far in this video. Welcome back, Pathless Peddlers. And if you're new to the channel, this is where we talk about all things adventure by bike, bike touring, bike packing, bike fishing, you name it, we do it on this channel. Revelate Design Works is known for really being one of those first companies to create and refine the modern bike packing bag as we know it. But recently they've actually also created some panniers. And in my hands, I have the latest iteration of the Nano panniers, their bike packing style panniers. So there have been a couple of iterations of this bag already, some where you can mount them separately, some with a different top attachment system. This is their latest one as of February of 2018. So you may find an older one and this review won't match up that description exactly, but just know that this is the latest version of the Nano Pannier. So I know some of you hardcore bike packers are gonna say, doesn't a pannier completely defeat the purpose of rackless bike packing? Yes, but unfortunately some of us aren't 6 feet tall and ride large frames and we need some extra capacity. In terms of volume, these offer about 13 liters of capacity. So similar to a really large seat bag, but unlike a seat bag, it's a little bit more uniformly distributed. So you don't have to be as particular about stuffing things in a particular order. In terms of weight, on our scales, these tip scales is about 500 grams, so still pretty lightweight for a pannier system. It's largely made of X-Pack. It's got a nice waterproof zipper, and the zipper is sewn onto this slightly stretchy material, so that does relieve some of the strain when you're closing the bags up with the zipper. Probably the most unique difference from a regular pannier as we know it is that there's really no hardware, so in that way it kind of still maintains that soft attachment system of bike packing bags. So the way that this works is you place both the panniers, they're permanently attached, on top of the rack. And at the bottom of each pannier is a webbing strap that you use to wrap around the bottom of your rack and tighten and cinch down. And on the top of the panniers, there are additional webbing straps so you can adjust the width. So if you have a really wide rack, you can extend it and it'll fit on that. Or if you have a really narrow rack, you can adjust it to fit on that as well. So pretty good rack compatibility. Oh, what else is there? While the pannier do offer some protection from the elements, they're pretty clear on the website that these are not waterproof. So if you're looking for a completely waterproof pannier, then consider Ortlieb. So I was trying to think of a way to illustrate how much you can fit inside each pannier. A sleeping pad might be the best bet. So here I have a Big Agnes Aircore light sleeping pad, and you can fit two of these easily into one pannier. So if you have a stuff sack that's roughly about this size, you can fit four of them in the bags with some room to spare, filling up the nooks and crannies. So in terms of the structure of these panniers, they are pretty minimally built. There is a little bit of a stiffener on the side of the pannier to prevent it from running inside your wheel. But other than that, it's really minimal. It's just kind of a bag. There aren't really organizational pockets to speak of. It's just kind of an open blank space. Other things to point out is this rubberized piece of fabric that lays transverse over your saddle. It's pretty hefty stuff, and I feel like it does give some grip so the panniers won't slide fore and aft. And off the bike, it also doubles as a handle. So that's it for kind of the features overview. I'm gonna jump into things I like and dislike about it. Again, this is a first look. This is not a full-on review, but these are kind of my initial impressions that I wanted to share with you guys if you're considering getting a pair of Nano panniers for yourself. So in terms of build quality, it's a lot like the other Revelate bags. It's really nicely assembled. It's well thought out. The materials are well chosen. So I definitely like the build quality of the panniers. Another big like is the volume. It's actually a nice volume. Because it's only 13 liters, it'll keep you fairly minimally packed. But I feel like in pannier configuration, the space is just more usable. You don't have to quite Tetris things in here as you would with a seat bag. So if you want to prevent yourself from carrying a bunch of stuff by using smaller panniers, but don't want to have to stuff things into a seat bag, then this is definitely a great option. Another big like, which is pretty obvious, is that it's short people friendly. Unlike a frame bag or a seat bag where your kind of usable space is really, really defined by your height and your frame size, anyone can use this. Tall, short, doesn't matter. As long as you can put a rack on your bike, you can use these guys. So let's move on to the dislikes. One dislike I had, is that I wish that there was some kind of Velcro strap that goes from this transverse part directly to the rack so that it would really prevent any fore and aft movement. As it is, if you take the time to really cinch things down, then it shouldn't move forward and backwards. But it would be nice if there was just one additional Velcro strap that really locks that down. And another slight dislike is with the webbing straps on the bottom. As it stands, it works well enough. You really have to just provide enough tension so you can even this out on your rack. I do wish, however, that this bottom webbing strap had some elasticity to it, just so that tension would constantly keep the bags in place. Another slight dislike, and I know previous versions of the Nano Painter did this, but I do wish that this could be somehow separated and you could run it on a front low rider rack. But as it is, you're only limited to a rear rack. I'm sure Eric has his reasons for doing this, probably complexity or to optimize production. But these painters would be the perfect size to run as front lowriders if you could, but you can't, so there you have it. So again, I do want to stress that this is a first look and not a full-on review, but I do want to give you guys my thoughts and feelings about this bag so far, if you're planning to buy it in the spring for whatever tours you have. I think it's well made. I don't think you'll be disappointed. My dislikes are kind of small niggling things, not complete deal breakers. So those are my thoughts. If you have any other questions, leave those in the comments below. I'll be sure to answer them. And if you like this video, like, share, subscribe. And until the next one, ride bikes, travel, and do good.